Hello guys, this is Anna Maria from Made by InkyJar, and this is the first tutorial in tutorial series that I'm doing in collaboration with XP Pen. This tutorial series will be about drawing cute cartoony girls. So, as you may know if you have seen my Instagram or my videos, my style is somewhere between manga and Disney. So now I'm going to show you some basic proportions principles, and then I'm going to show you how I do it. And for that, I have a very cute book about drawing mangas. So let's get to the page where it's about drawing heads. So basically it says that you should start with an oval. I start with a circle, but we'll get to that. Next important things are these lines. So you have the eye line, which is right in the middle of the head. So the upper half is reserved for the forehead and hairline, and the bottom half is reserved for the nose and mouth. This is pretty much the same how I do it, except that I change the mouth and nose lines a bit. And now I will show you my way of doing it, although I must say it isn't the best or the only way to do it, it's just my way and how I learned it. As you can see, I'm starting with a circle and I'm adding these section lines, which just show where the eyes go and the line of the nose. They also indicate the direction of the face, so where the face is turned to and what the person is looking at. Then I roughly sketch the jawline and ears just to indicate where they are placed. And then the next thing is to determine where are the eyes, eyebrows, nose and mouth. Drawing's eyes are placed always on the half of the head, and so the upper part is reserved for the forehead and hair, and then I add the nose at the half of the bottom part of the head, which is actually 1/4 of the head, and then the mouth goes in the half of that last quarter. To place the eyebrows, I use this trick, and that's adding this sleeping or superhero mask over the face, and that shows exact position of the eyes as well as the direction and position of eyebrows. And as I mentioned earlier, the only difference is that I like to put my noses a little bit higher, so they are on the half of the bottom half of the face. And I just use some simple square shapes to indicate the position. Now for the side view, the only thing that really changes are the angles. So the side that is closer to us will be wider than the side that is further away from us. And this is applicable to all face features. So the eye that is closer to us will be wider than the one that is further away from us. Let's test these rules on some of my previous works, shall we? So here is the front view, and as you can see, I'm pretty much following all the proportions. So let's see on the 3/4 view. So I'm still maintaining the proportions, starting with a circle, having the half line for the eyes, and I'm just paying attention to the width of the facial features. So this eye that is closer to us has to be wider than the one that is further away from us. Another important thing to mention is the space between the eyes, and it should be equal to the width of the eye. And in frontal view, that's very easy because you just have the same width of the eyes. And in side view, there is a bit of foreshortening, so you have the less space between the eyes than in frontal view. Now let's draw a girl together and apply all these before mentioned rules. And in the upper corner you have a screen recording of this drawing so you can better see it maybe, and also you have a video of me drawing so you can see which shortcuts I'm using, which brush strokes I'm adding, etc. Now let's draw her and then I will tell you about the next tutorials. Now I'm almost done with this girl, so I can tell you more about her. So this is a girl I designed for this tutorial series, and in this tutorial I only drew her face, and in next tutorial I will draw her hair and show you guys how to draw hair on girls, and then in that tutorial I will let you know what to expect from the next one. And here is my quick proportions test, so let's see if everything is alright. the width of the eyes, the height of the eyes, it's okay, the space between the eyes, and overall proportions. So everything is by the book. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you XP Pen for this lovely collaboration. And if you liked it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe not to miss the next ones. Bye bye!